Today I'm going to go over the BL Touch on the Ramps 1.4 board. In order to do this, I need to explain some pins to you. So to start with, we have our end stop pins. We have X-Min, we have X-Max, we have Y-Min, we have Y-Max, we have Z-Min, and then Z-Max. Inside here, the top row of pins are our signal pins. The next row over is our ground pin, and the last row, being the outside row, is our voltage pins. Now we have over here our pins for our servos, which we're going to need a set of these. So these three pins would be our first servo, and then it would go all the way over to the fourth servo. So to start with, we have our top row of pins, which is our signal pins. Then we have our voltage pins in the middle, and then on the bottom, we have our ground pins. Now, in order to energize these pins or provide voltage to work, we need to jump power to the voltage rail. In order to do that, we have three sets of pins that we need to consider here. We have our VCC, we have our 5-volt pin, then we have our ground pin. So in order to provide power, we have to jump the VCC pin to the 5-volt pin. In order to do that, we use a jumper. So we just place it on these two pins, and now this pin, or these set of pins, will be energized when the power from the USB is provided. So the first connector that we have to worry about is our servo connector. And as you can see, the first wire here, being the brown one, is our ground. Our middle pin is voltage, and our yellow pin on the end is our signal pin. So to connect it, all we have to do is line it up over here, apply a little bit of pressure, and there you go. So the next jumper, or excuse me, the next wire that we need to connect is our signal wire for the end stop. So the black wire is ground and the white wire is signal. And what we want to connect to is our Z min over here. So we're going to line it up. And there we go. In a moment, I'll show you how to connect the USB to the computer and then how to load the Marlin firmware. Okay, to connect the serial cable, we want to connect the big end to the USB port down here and the small end to the computer. Now you're going to hear a beep. And in a moment, I'll show you how to load the Marlin firmware. Okay, what we're going to do is open up the Marlin folder for 1.1.9. We're going to open up the Marlin subfolder. We're then going to press M on the keyboard and scroll down to marlin.ino and open that up. Okay, now that we're in the Marlin folder, first thing we want to do is do a search on BL Touch. First thing we need to do once we're on the BL Touch line is uncomment it, so that we can use it. Next, I'm going to uncomment the delay for the BL Touch. Now, you might want to modify this later on to your liking, but I'm just showing it for the example. Next, we want to check on number of servos. So we're going to search on num_serve. And we're going to uncomment this line.
Now it says number of servos is 3, but we only have 1, and it would be inside the BL touch. Next, as you can see, there's specified 300 milliseconds for a servo delay. If you had had more than one servo, what you would do, for instance, if we had 2 specified, then we would say 300 again. But in this case, we only have 1. So next, what we want to do is load the firmware. So we're going to check first to see that we have the right board selected, which we do. It's the Mega 2560 for the Arduino. And we have a COM port selected. So all we have to do is compile and upload with the upload button. And in a moment, I'll show you in Chronerface how to test it. Okay, first thing we're going to do is open up Chronerface. We're going to connect to the printer. We're going to type M119 to check the status of the end steps. And as you can see, X-min and Y-min say triggered because they're not connected, and Z-min says open. So in a moment, I'm going to Z or home the axis for the Z-axis. But keep in mind, we're not going to touch the ramps board because it's energized, only the sensor. So here we go. Okay, now that it's been homed with our finger, we're going to type M119 again in Chronerface and see what the status says. And as you can see, it says triggered. So if you like my video, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.